Welcome to part three of my top 10 and PlayStation games that started with a PS1 and is going to end with a PS4. So, you already saw my top 10 list of the best PS2 games ever, along with the honorable mentions. But now, it's time for the PSP to take its own turn, ladies and gentlemen. So, all I can say is that the PSP has a lot of good games. I really love the PSP. I got a lot of games and all that. There's so many awesome games, to be exact. I was first introduced to the PSP 10 years ago by my cousin, and I first played the game Lumines, which I'll mention shortly. But enough of that. Enough of the trips down memory lane. So, let's see my top 10 games, alright? Number 10, Monster Hunter series. It is a good series, and it has a good gameplay, graphics, story. A little bit like Pokemon, but still a lot better than Pokemon. Pokemon can mean a bad word in the Sony PlayStation. So I just said, so before you jump the gun, I just felt the need of saying that it's better than Pokemon. Number 9, Jeanne d'Arc. Jeanne d'Arc is a fantasy version of the story of Joan of Arc, which took place in 15th century France during the Hundred Years' War. It's a great tactical role-playing game, and I really enjoyed it. It's fantasized because it has elves and characters that are anthropomorphic animals, such as lions, wolves, pumas, foxes, and so on. You know. Number 8, Tactics Ogre. Let us clean together. If you really like Final Fantasy Tactics, you're going to love this one, folks. Believe me. Tactics Ogre is one of the coolest game franchises I have ever played in my entire life. You got to try this one, ladies and gentlemen. Number 7, Final Fantasy Tactics, The War of the Lions. A remake of the original PS1 title, but with new features such as animated sequences that have voice acting. Ramza, the protagonist, is voiced by Phil Lamar. Delita is voiced by Robin Atkin Downs, and Princess Ovelia is voiced by Kerry Walgren, sexy actress. Also, it features some characters from Final Fantasy XII. I mean, it features a character from Final Fantasy XII, Balthier, and there's also Lusso from Final Fantasy Tactics Advance. Number 6, Grand Theft Auto, Liberty City Stories. This game is a prequel to Grand Theft Auto 3, one of my favorite GTA titles ever. In this game, you play as the one and only Tony Cipriani. Don't mess with that guy. He'll make an example out of you. Or should I say, he'll send you a laundry version of your own blood-stained clothes. Number 5, SOCOM, Fireteam Bravo 2. SOCOM is one of my favorite military combat games. It's really cool. I enjoyed it a lot more than the first one. I heard Fireteam Bravo is 3, but I feel so stupid for not playing it yet, of course. Number 4, Killzone Liberation. Killzone Liberation continues where the first game left off. You still fight against a Hellgas, but you battle a new enemy, General Armin Matrak, and also against Colonel Kobar, the bloodthirsty Hellgast. Number 3, Final Fantasy IV, The Complete Collection. I was so happy when they remade Final Fantasy IV for the DS, and even more happier when it came out for the PSP. It also has a remake version for the PSP of Final Fantasy IV, The After Years, which is a good sequel to Final Fantasy IV. Number 2, Crisis Core, Final Fantasy VII. It is my second favorite PS2 title, and you play as a protagonist of the game, Sack Fair. It tells of the events before Final Fantasy VII and how Sephiroth became the bad guy. And now it's time for the honorable mentions before my most favorite PSP title. Okay, of the honorable mentions I have are Ace Combat, Joint Assault. It's a really awesome game. So the Ace Combat series usually took place in fictional versions of Earth, but this one I liked a lot because it took place in the real world version of Earth. And it features things such as the economic recession of 2009. Another honorable mention is Grand Theft Auto Vice City Stories, the prequel to Vice City, in which Tommy Vercetti is not the protagonist, but the brother of Lance Vance, the backstabber in Vice City. Other honorable mentions are Shin Megami Tensei Persona 3 Portable Version, Star Ocean Second Evolution, Lumines, my first PSP game, thanks to my cousin, White Knight Chronicles Origins, and Assassin's Creed Bloodlines. Okay, ladies and gentlemen, the moment you've been waiting for. Number one, Kingdom Hearts, Birth by Sleep. Birth by Sleep is a prequel to one of my most favorite video game franchises of all time. In this game, you get to play not only as one main character, but as three different main characters, three different stories. Aventus, Terra, and Aqua. And you see Zack Fair in this one, and also a younger Hercules, and Snow White, and Princess Aurora, and the Disney villains that you all know. So that is pretty much everything about the PSP. So stay tuned for the PS3, ladies and gentlemen. Later.